mobile games are going big. Free Fire Max is now available on PC.
In the hills of New Hampshire, where the tallest mountains in the east rise majestically towards crisp blue New England skies, lies a century-old stretch of railroad track winding its way down through the Mount Washington Valley, its rails kept alive by the small, hard-working, and wonderful Conway Scenic Railroad nestled in the valley below. Located in the quaint village of North Conway, New Hampshire, on the edge of the valley, This tourist railroad continues the tradition of train travel as if it were another era. People of all ages gather here to enjoy the hustle and bustle of railroading as it was years ago. Much has changed here since 1872, when these tracks were first put down. But some things will never change. It's the hard work and dedication of the men and women who make this railroad exist yesterday and today, and people like you who love trains and continue to be part of the excitement of the Conway Scenic Railroad. Conductors, dispatchers, and engineers are busy running passenger-filled trains up and down the track, keeping these rails polished and action-packed, all with the same determination and enthusiasm that brought the railroads through this valley over 120 years ago. People behind the scene are also hard at work, like owner Russ Seabold, making sure everyone is enjoying the atmosphere at the Conway Scenic Railroad.
What we want to do is we want to continue doing what we are in terms of providing a site where there is preservation of a railroad. If they come here and they have a good time, I mean, they get value for their money, they get a train ride, they understand a little bit more about trains, they have an experience with a steam locomotive, you know, that's what we're here for.
Ever felt trapped by endless ads while watching your favorite videos? One click on privacyadblocker.com and say goodbye to ad interruptions. Not just ad-free.
Gary Webster, the operations manager, keeps the trains running smoothly up to the platform day in and day out, particularly during some of the special events. Today, the railroad is having a birthday. Every year, riders and crew have some extra fun by running extra trains to celebrate August the 4th, 1974, the day the Conway Scenic Railroad was born.
All aboard!
Rusted rails on this stretch of track are a thing of the past.
The tracks were laid down in 1872 as part of the Portsmouth Great Falls and Conway Railroad. Passenger service ended in December 1961. Up until that time, you still had the ability to board the train here in North Conway, head down the branch to Rawlinsford, New Hampshire, join the main line to Portland, and go right into Boston's North Station.
Today, the ride ends here in Conway, 5.5 miles south of the Conway Scenic's main terminal. Here you can get out, look around, and imagine what it was like years ago when students attending nearby Kennett High School were dropped off by the B&M passenger trains in much the same manner. After 10:55 runs around the train, it's time to head back to North Conway, catching some magnificent views along the way, like the Moat Range or Cathedral Ledge, where rock climbers from around the country challenge the steep and dangerous cliff. Pulling its cars up one of the steepest grades in the East, 1055 works hard. But the 3.2% grade is no match for this 124-ton Alco. 1055 is a 1950 S4 diesel. This 1,000-horsepower engine originally worked for the Portland Terminal Company and is now Conway Scenic's number one diesel, pulling more trains each season than any of the other three operating locomotives on the Conway Scenic roster. Now fully restored, 1055 runs around the train for another scheduled departure in front of the magnificent North Conway Railroad Station.
The station was built in 1874 and today remains pretty much as it was then. The terminal area is on the National Register of Historic Places and is one of the few original complete terminal areas still existing in the country with its original buildings.
That is one of the special elements of this railroad, the fact that all the buildings are original, right down to the air-driven turntable, which can spin any 100-ton locomotive right in front of the roundhouse. Today, inside this four-stall facility, boiler crews are hard at work inside the steam locomotive 7470, Conway Scenic's flagship. Its own motive power in much the same fashion here inside this engine house. For 82 years, this was a familiar sight inside and out. In the beginning, business was good for the B&M. During the 1950s, however, automobile travel eroded passenger counts to the point where the B&M could no longer afford to run scheduled passenger service. Over the next 20 years, freight service declined, and the B&M abandoned portions of the Conway branch. Finally, on Halloween morning, October the 31st, 1972, a diesel switcher, pulling only a caboose, headed south through the cold rain. People watching felt they would never see an engine in Boston and Maine colors ride these rails again. Little did they know. Years now, the Conway Scenic Railroad has hosted the Boston and Maine Railroad Historical Society's annual B&M Day, a day to pay tribute to the once mighty B&M Railroad. On the second Saturday in August every year, folks gather to relive the grand era when the Boston and Maine Railroad provided train travel in and out of the Mount Washington Valley. Every summer, eager rail fans ride in these restored coaches, experiencing what it was like to be part of the B&M as it was over 30 years ago. One person who knows what it was like better than most of us is Rudy Hood, who was a B&M engineer for over 20 years. Rudy operated all kinds of motive power for the B&M and even operated the same engine during its heyday.
I started out in 48. Well, they had the old FTs, they call them, the earlier diesel, and the F2s and the F3s. The FTs, you had to have a fireman. If you were a fireman, hey, she's getting hot, you had to go back and fill in the fans. They wouldn't do it automatically like this one does.
Rudy feels right at home in 4266. This beautifully restored EMDF-7 with its huge 16-cylinder, 1,500-horsepower engine, still can bring a thrill worth capturing on film as it runs by this group of B&M rail fans. Is a red caboose packed with rail enthusiasts. And Roger Robar, who is riding in his own personal caboose, soaking up the age-old sounds of railroading.
I've always loved trains since I was a little kid. My father used to take me down to the railroad station to watch the trains come by. And this was back when they still had steam. That desire, that urge is still in there. This has been a fantasy of mine of owning a piece of real railroad equipment. So I jumped at the chance to buy into this caboose. There's so many good people that's involved in this hobby. It's, all I can say is it's just the greatest.
Attention, everyone.
I've been trying to catch the Pontiac Bandit for 8 years. You know how many months that is?
96.
80, 46 years, months.
You're not very good at math.
With Boston and Main Day behind them, early morning crews are back to work on 7470, getting New Hampshire's only operating standard gauge coal-fired steam locomotive ready for the railroad's most colorful event of the year.
Just make sure that thing is over the hull.
This thing, when you come through.
That's got to go through that, too.
You got it.
Conway Scenic's own Roundhouse Rat, a nickname given to master mechanic Courtney Gregg, leads his crew through the maintenance procedures under this 160-ton locomotive.
All right, we've got to get this main rod up and see where it... Well, is that going to stay?
Yeah.
All right.
Now, they're kind of a novelty today because you don't see that many of them. You know, they, in the heyday of steam, that's all people used to see. But today, about the only place I can see a steam engine is a tourist railroad.
Built in 1921 by the Grand Trunk Railroad in Montreal, this 060 is over 70 years old, and the tender care that is given to her today will keep her 51-inch drivers turning a long time.
These engines were built way over their design. They were built to last, and they were built to run virtually forever as long as they were maintained.
While sounds from inside stall number one escape outside, yard crews are busy preparing for the Conway Scenic Railroad's biggest event of the season. At the end of each summer, everyone here looks forward to celebrating Rail Fans Day, a Saturday in mid-September when the Conway Scenic Railroad opens the throttle another notch on everything this railroad has to offer. It's a big day, and switching begins weeks before to make sure everything is in place in this busy yard. Switching to a railroad is what coal is like to a steam engine. It's the fuel that fires an operation like the Conway Scenic and sends completed trains down the track. While these folks are working the north yard today, let's take a break in the action and go inside the depot and look back into the rich history here at the Conway Scenic Railroad. Standing in the museum, one cannot help but wonder about all the travelers that have passed through this magnificent structure over the past century. On display here in the museum, railroad artifacts from the past transport you into the bygone era of train travel. It was a time when crowds would gather and ride the rails, when the town depot was the center of most people's daily lives. In 1874, noted architect Nathaniel J. Bradley built this proud station for the Portsmouth, Great Falls, and Conway Railroad. After the Civil War, the pent-up demand for railroads to transport the products of northern New Hampshire's farms and forests, along with the need to open the growing tourism market, brought about a fever of railroad activity to the Mount Washington Valley area. In 1878, the Portsmouth, Great Falls, and Conway became a division of the mighty Eastern Railroad. Then, 12 years later, was absorbed into the competing Boston and Maine. In 1890, the B&M also took over the rail lines through Franconia Notch, Bethlehem, and Bretton Woods on the west side of the mountains, as well as the Cog Railway to the summit of Mount Washington. The line from Portsmouth to North Conway and Intervale became known as the B&M Conway Branch. By the turn of the century, the Boston and Maine opened new avenues of commerce for rural New Hampshire. Thousands of tourists in luxurious parlor cars, Pullman sleeping cars, and elegant diners arrived to spend vacations in grand hotels and small inns. Logging railroads came into town to drop off their loads for the mills to finish into lumber. Granite blocks from local quarries were also brought to town, and the B&M would ship these goods to the big city's market. During the 1930s and 40s, B&M snow trains brought hundreds of skiers to the mountainous region, with almost 5,000 passengers sometimes passing through North Conway Station during those winter weekends. No one then would have suspected that the end of local railroading was in sight for this prosperous area. But it happened fast. With the advent of the automobile, passenger loads dropped to the point where the B&M could no longer afford to run passenger service to the area. On December the 2nd, 1961, the last regularly scheduled self-propelled B&M Budliner pulled away from the station for the final time. For the next 20 years, B&M Freight Service continued three times a week to North Conway, but this too fell victim to hard times being experienced by America's railroads. On October the 31st, 1972, freight service was formally abandoned by the Boston and Maine. The grand old days of railroading seemed to be over for this station. The neglected buildings stood empty, with their future looking bleak. But two local businessmen wisely purchased the terminal area and its rundown buildings in the hopes that someone would come along and restore dignity and pride back to this abandoned rail yard. Their hopes were answered, for in the winter of 1968, a man by the name of Dwight Smith, himself a B&M veteran, paid a visit to North Conway and immediately fell in love with the old branch line terminal.
In 1968, there was a special rail trip run from Boston to North Conway to reenact the old ski trains, and rode up here to North Conway, and there was an hour or two layover. And when I got off the train and looked at that station and that roundhouse and that turntable and the area and the views, the light bulb lit. I mean, really, as basic as that. I looked around that facility and I said, oh my God, what a place for a tourist railroad.
Dwight knew what he wanted to do, so within a month, he was back in North Conway, meeting with the owners, Carol Reed and Bill Levy. After agreeing to establish a tourist railroad, Dwight set out to secure trackage rights with a B&M railroad and felt so optimistic that he went out looking for a steam locomotive. His search ended in an old roundhouse up in Sarnia, Ontario. There he found ex-Canadian National 7470 sitting alone since 1960 after switching for an industrial plant. Following an inspection and some dickering, Dwight was the owner of an 060 steam locomotive with no place to run it, because the B&M had decided not to sell the trackage rights to Dwight and his partners. In the meantime, 7470 was shipped and stored at Maine Central's Rigby Yard in South Portland, Maine. There, a group of devoted volunteers spent long weekend hours restoring the steam locomotive. For 3 years, the B&M dragged its feet and finally sold the tracks to a big developer, even though the B&M had been ordered by the Interstate Commerce Commission to sell to anyone willing to continue train operations. Dwight challenged the B&M, and the courts ruled in his favor. So with this good news, Dwight and his band of volunteers stepped up their efforts to restore the North Conway station.
I could see from the outside that it had potential, but inside it was depressing. It was like a haunted house. I mean, the windows were boarded up, and beneath the boards were shards of glass. I mean, things were all broken up. There was trash and litter everywhere. The woodwork was black. I mean, black. It was, it was, you know, 100 years of soot and smoke.
In 1973, the B&M declared bankruptcy, further delaying the start of the long-planned excursion railroad. But Dwight and his volunteers ignored these setbacks and continued working, rebuilding the roundhouse roof, which was the biggest job of all. The end was in sight. By May of 1974, Reed, Smith, and Levy incorporated the Conway Scenic Railroad. A few months later, 7470 and her proud crew pulled their first revenue train. The date, August the 4th, 1974. 6.5 years of frustration had finally come to an end, and the Conway Scenic Railroad was operating.
Start clean with Clorox.
Brings us back here today with crews putting the final touches on preparations for Rail Fans Day. Roadmaster Wayne Allen peers down the rails as he and his crew maintain a section of track at the West Side Curve. Wayne, with the help of modern equipment as well as hand tools, has been in charge of the entire 7.5 mile stretch of track since the Conway Scenic Railroad began running trains over them. Switch engine 15 is being rewarded after a long day of pushing and pulling cuts of railroad cars around the yard. This original Maine Central Railroad 44 tonner looks just as good as it did when it was built back in 1945, and now enjoys a second life running on the rails of this operating museum here at the Conway Scenic. With everything in place, crews retire to their bunk cars and cabooses for an evening of rest where they will sleep overnight and wake to the excitement of Rail Fans Day. Day begins early, and the railroad crews meet one last time before things get underway.
Roger Les, Howard Otterberg, keep the folks at a reasonable distance from the track.
This morning, Carl Vitters is lighting the fire in 7470's boiler so she can build up steam and soon take us on the magnificent foliage runs through the colorful valley. It's 8 o'clock, and the high rail heads to Conway. Now it's time to begin a day of trains and people, run-bys and photo opportunities from one end of the line to the other. A day when everyone pulls out all the stops and celebrates railroading for its own sake.
Thank you. 266 and throw it back up on the engine lead.
Thank you.
As the clouds in the valley begin to break up, there is a sense that something is about to happen here as a cool, crisp night takes us to tomorrow.
There's nothing more powerful than you. Making your thing happen. Really going for it. Doing business on your terms. Giving it your all. Making a difference. And loving what you do. Every single day. Feeling fearless, fulfilled, free. When there's nothing holding you back, what would your thing be?
Now, steam locomotive 7470 finally emerges from the ROM house. This is why people come from miles around to see 7470 whistle through the valley.
Well, what's different about steam is so much of what you see in the locomotive, I mean, you see the working parts. You have more of an idea of what's making that engine run. I mean, you see the steam, you hear the hiss, and you see the rods, and you know, going back and forth, and you get a sense of, oh, that's how it works. There's a lot of activity, and we turn the turntable, and I mean, there's a whole sort of like a ritual, and people enjoy watching that.
'74-'70 fills the air with the smell of coal and excitement. Then the crew takes her down the track for the first order of the day. Thank you.
once you dump the ashes, then we back down the hill to the yard limit board or just a little beyond, and then the engineer will work the engine up the hill. He'll put the brakes on and then open the throttle up.
It's awesome, you know, the power of the engine. Steam pressure on 18 to 24 inch pistons can move an awful lot of weight.
When you hear the whistle from the steam locomotive, it's like you can hear it through the valley.
Test, and after all the passengers are loaded on train number 10, a quick whistle lets everyone know that steam-powered foliage runs through the colorful valley are at last at hand.
All aboard!
Get ready!
To live is to journey. That's why Bridgestone is relentlessly seeking ways to improve it. Never settling for the easy answer. So your journey can be smarter, safer, better. Today and for years to come. Because getting people down the road matters. But getting generations down one? That's what really matters. Bridgestone. Solutions for your journey.
if New England has a reputation for anything, is for its foliage. A 2 or 3 week window right in there where it's just, and it's like watching the most magnificent sunset. And it's all over. I mean, you look around and you see so many different colors, and it changes by the day and by the hour. Different areas along the railroad change at different times.
One of the trackside locations known for its color is West Side Curve, where Les McDonald, Conway's scenic still photographer, is quickly setting up his cameras to catch a shot of 7470 for this once-a-year photo opportunity. In the cab, Courtney waits for Les to finish so he can pull his train up and out of the grade here at West Side Curve.
Never miss a beat with TD Clear. No interest, just a simple monthly fee.
Conway, 7470 rounds Kennett Curve, giving it everything she's got. Towards North Conway, some passengers have caught the spirit of rail travel here in the comfortable first-class accommodations of the Gertrude Emma, the railroad's parlor observation car. Built by the Pullman Palace Car Company of Illinois in 1898, this beautifully restored sleeper parlor observation car first traveled on the all-new Pennsylvania Limited between New York and Chicago. With its beautiful wood-carved interior and fine amenities, the Gertrude Emma was renamed by this railroad after G. Smith, wife of one of the Conway Scenic Railroad's founders, in recognition of her contributions. The large plate glass windows, individual wicker chairs, and open observation platform make this car a delightful place to view the brilliant fall colors in the valley. With another scheduled train approaching the station platform, passengers wait inside the warm station, seeking refuge from the cool fall air. From the warmth of the station, you can hear the train approaching. Sounds carry in this crisp autumn air, just like the leaves swept aloft by a chill mountain gust and left to fall like rain. Allowing a little more time for 7470 to charge through the woods. In all kinds of fall weather. With winter fast approaching, a snow-covered Mount Washington signals the end of fall. Backs onto the turntable one last time and eases into its warm stall. Farewell to its friends, to the mountains, and to the early winter sky. Inside the warm roundhouse, Diesel 4266 is waiting to venture out into the cold, snowy weather ahead. Barely visible in the season's first blizzard, Russ and Gary ready Snow Train 4266 for its series of final runs of the year. Inside the Brass Whistle gift shop, Dawn and Tracy prepare for the holidays. The gifts and souvenirs are especially appropriate for this time of year.
I just got a link for a delivery. Did you get me a birthday gift?
Yeah. You should check with Jeannie, though.
Why?
Because I forgot your birthday.
Download Norton Genie to find out.
Out in the driving snow, train 4266 quietly pulls away from the station, heading into a winter wonderland.
I want people to take something away from here, not just a memory of a train ride. I want them to take away a piece of the history. Have some fun, understand the past, come back and visit us some more.
Thank you.
Born in Henry.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Yeah, I guess it is a homemade paint job. Oh, one of them stuck. One of them stuck. Excuse me, one of the trains is stuck. Oh, I tried to get. Oh, man.
It's all right. They'll take care of it.
All right.
Come on, let's go.
All right. Oh, look at these. Here's some videos over here now. I'm trying to do that. But that's gone.
A bad, bad engineer. I'm going to let them see the derails again.
Wow, very small layouts, huh?
See the engine in the front there.
Yeah, that's Amtrak, right?
Well, it's Amtrak, but it's got a camera in it, and it shows up here.
Oh. All right, that's cool. Goodness me. Wow. That's a long freight train. All right. Let's try and get a crossing shot. There we go. Man. The rear end device there.
Red. Flashing rear end device.
I don't think we're going to find any steam engines on this railway, huh?
Who's shorting DCC?
Is it me?
Blue
or red?
Well, they're both together on the same booster or not?
No.
This little train here.
Got it.
And then underneath the engine, or sometimes it, the engine, and sometimes it's there in the
center. What they call a slider, which is like a
little steamer
about that long. And it's
a tank engine. Loaded.
Yeah,
so if you have one spot that's a little bit dirty,
get a tracking shot
it'll carry forward. And some of the newer engines now, they'll put capacitors in them.
So
if you have a good spot in the layout, then you just carry it across and just ignore it. You won't even notice it.
I feel like I'm filming an episode of Thomas, because they used models in their show.
Yeah, I'm hoping that maybe have something like that with him.
What a busy railway.
I saw that. Lionel makes a really, really good set. We saw that at the Springfield show.
Oh, well, we were at Springfield.
Sorry for the people in the way, guys. Oh, okay, sorry. Let's get another crossing shot with the trains. Pretty nice shot. A little. They have a little tank engine. I wonder what type of tank engine this is.
Black one.
Oh.
That's all I know.
All right. Whoa! Look how big his phone is. Holy mackerel! Alrighty. I'm trying not to get faces either. That's the tricky part.
Use up all your space.
You shoot Nerf darts.
Yes. I think that's a. Yeah, that's Paw Patrol. That's an old. Gauge, is this gauge one?
Yes, it is.
Oh,
this is the first one with the way too thick windows. No plate, no gas, windows.
Yeah. Oh, that's a beauty. Yeah,
the second one, the third one, they're more like the numbers on this one. Yeah, it's thinner they are.
Marbles. Here are some more trains. That's an engine, it looks like. Diesel, steam, all kinds of good stuff. My goodness. There's just trains. We are now making our way to the displays. The, what are they called? The, model train displays. Check those out right now. Sorry, guys. Sorry, guys. We had trouble getting over here. A lot of people were in the way, so they had to come over here instead. Oh, man. We have a steam and a diesel engine here.
They're kind of low. This is their. Oh! You see that?
No.
All righty. Oh my gosh, look at this.
We do too.
So cool.
And enjoy your show.
I hope you're
Whoa.
We're going to go to other things.
How cool that is. A bit of a small layout, but it's all, but it's cool, see? Antique. Yeah. And that's the kind I think you grew up with. The old Lionel. Here's the island of Surador layouts. You can see here that's Thomas and... Oh, sorry. Now Toby, is that bird or... Is that bird or... Oh, that's Aaron. Thomas. Toby down there. See if we can get a cross and chop between them. Let's see. Wow. Trying not to show faces, but it's... That's really hard to do. Especially the little kids. I'm assuming that hot, salty diesel... Rosie, Boosie, Oliver, Gordon, and Henry. I think that's just of all of them. And we got Harold the helicopter up there too. Always nice to see. Always nice to see. Now. Oh, that's a diesel. Well, good Amtrak. Wow. This is such a pretty layout, too. Give a little tour around the layouts. Yep. Trying not to do faces. Again, that is hard. Not yet. Maybe. Get him again. Yeah, there's only one train on this layout. That's all right. Well, we got more layouts to go through. We got some more Lionel trains right over here. Oh, there's a third train coming. Wow. This is like a pretty cool layout. Here comes a steam locomotive. And that's doing track the track. Yep.
Oh, dollar store.
Dollar store, whoa.
Dollar store video.
You mean dollar, you mean dollar, you mean Dollar Tree, you mean? None of them are pulling cabooses, except for that one.
Awesome. Yep.
Coca-Cola, Dairy Queen. Oh, it's all right. It's okay. Oh, excuse us. Excuse me. Oh, wow. An old house, an old station. We got, an old crossing, excuse me. Wow, wait.
This is the test track. If you purchase a locomotive and
general store model, the model train. I think that's a restaurant.
when you purchase a
locomotive. I don't know what this is.
Here comes.
Oh, why can't we get all three in here? All three? Oh, yeah. That's good to see. We got bulldozers and vehicles are here. And here's one of the smallest layouts here. Do you think this is the smallest one here, or do you think this is a smaller one?
You want to take a quick look?
An old witch's house, it looks like, maybe? I don't know. Maybe an old witch's house? Oh, wow, that's going to take a long time. We have an old rail yard here. We have trains parked waiting to just go ahead to leave. Sicko, that's what it is, Sicko. I believe this is an old shipping yard over here.
Well, good luck with it. Like I said, there's people around. Do you live around here?
Yeah, well, Newbury, yeah.
Jesus. Down by the docks, that's the place to be. Down by the docks, gateway to the sea.
Rose is my favorite. That's layout, just the Enterprise.
Wow. That's what I thought.
So
that's
this
what
is
I
what's
thought.
New. This is what's new.
Ooh.
Okay. Did you do this at your open house 2 weeks ago? Hingham.
Yes.
Is this train we're waiting to get to go ahead? Pull out. And here's the loop-de-loop track. Remember, these loop tracks are not real, they're just for fun. A whole bunch of cars and trucks and stuff like that. Look at all that. Yeah, like that. This is a... Holy smokes! Look how long this train is.
Yep. Must be stopped at the station.
Here's another layout. We got a cam. Yeah, it does. Uh-oh. These cameras are low quality, huh? And they sometimes don't work properly.
Oh, there you are. Hi.
Oh.
Say hi.
Oh, it's a Boston and Maine train, I think. I think I can tell.
Oh, it's coming to us.
Look, there I am. Yeah. Right there.
There you are.
See if I can.
Hello, everyone.
Don't hit the plexiglass
here. Oh. Oh, I think we get a crossing shot. Let's get a crossing shot. I bet that other train has one too. Because I can... Yeah. There's another one over there. Goodness. Here's a siding. Oh wait, I think this train is meant to be going too, but I think it stopped.
Yeah, they took that.
Anyway, I think this is one of the train that has a camera inside of them. But this is the train with a lot of cars, the Santa Fe. I swear, Santa Fe pulls a lot of cars.
Where do you want to go now?
Here's some videos of the trains going by. Oh, mono trains, it looks like. Wow, that's a beauty.
home is when you get incorporated. Let me try and get one more. That's a beauty. Hand over. And over here we have testing track. We have G scale, I think, Lionel, and all and stuff like that. Yep. And DVDs. Ooh. Look at that.
Penn Central units were supposed to be for the body art service that captured those, but you could see by this, they were used for a little bit more.
Wow. Let's move along. Have some old DVDs here. Even a Lionel station, or signal. And some more DVDs, and another, oh, it's the orange line. I could tell that was the orange line. Some more video action for you. And some more train, looks like some more train pictures. And some, are these VHSs? Ooh, VHSs. Look at that. That's awesome. Yeah, those are perfect for Christmas time. That's Boston and Maine. I'm a fan of the Boston and Maine. Conrail, CSX layout. That comes with the multiple track piece. You have train, more trains here, some cups. And some more train pictures as far as you can see. And we have even more train pictures over here. Refreshments, anyone? They got Doritos, barbecue, and all kinds of other stuff. Those big pretzels too, and popcorn. Who doesn't love popcorn? Polar Express. Yeah. A Lion Chief set.
I like the clock.
The Glock?
Clock.
Oh, clock.
You got a train clock on your wall.
I thought it meant Glock, but clock. I said Glock, but I was meant to say clock. Glock, clock, clock. stuffed toys and stuff. And some toys. Is this an Ertl? Yeah, an Ertl Thomas. That's cool.
I don't know why they sell a Thomas with broken wheels. A Sodor Celebration Thomas, I think? Another Ertl one. Man, I remember playing with the toys like that. And there's even some pick and play Thomas and other stuff like that here. Tons of other stuff. Cars. Wow. Look at all this stuff, man. Is that like a Big Bird Express train or? That's Sesame Street. I don't watch Sesame Street anymore, but that's more for babies anyway. Ooh, that's a big fire truck. Moving around. Mm-hmm. Some more stuff over here. The rolling stock. Set pieces.
That one with the tablecloth.
Train shells for parts.
Thank you, sir.
Good job. In case someone wants to repair a train. And some other stuff here. This? Oh yeah.
I travel like all of
it's a clock, huh?
Massachusetts.
Has everything. Temperature.
Do you have anything clock? Besides that, like a tool or whatever.
Wow.
I'm interested.
That's awesome.
So it's time to come down and see you to get that stuff if you like. Like I said, I'm just not sure what you want for And I'd have to see it because conditions everything.
Conditions poor.
New England Railroads. And look at this train over here. That's an oldie.
It sure is. Keep going straight down.
Right down over here?
Yeah, straight down, back down the other one.
Oh. More train stuff? That's a G-scale. G-scale Polar Express coaches. I'm trying not to show faces. It's hot. Here's some more stuff. And over here we got more tracks, more trains, more literally everything. Some of those trains just may not work anymore. Who knows? Maybe they will, maybe they won't. Just so long as they're tested first. And another Polar Express car. What are the odds? Oh, we have a breakdown train. We have some rolling stock, cars, engines, more stuff like that. And I think these are all the wooden ones. Wooden trains. Thomas. Tank engine. And those are all, I think, all wooden Thomas stuff. Pretty cool.
Correct one, and not the one that was broken. Wasn't painted. Yeah, it wasn't. I mean, I didn't pay a lot for it.
Oh, okay. Kind of looks sexy, I guess. That's fine. Alright, here's some more things. We even got a layout piece here. I think these are O scale? Or Bachman, whatever. I don't know what they're using those nowadays. And some more rolling stock and track you can buy. And some more, I think more rolling stock. You can never have enough rolling stock, can you?
Okay, enjoy it.
Yeah. Oh, no, I enjoy it. I do. Okay. When I get it running, I can't, you know, I love getting a basket case.
I think these are all anime stuff here.
The anime, yeah.
Because I know that people like anime.
A lot of people do.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the men like it.
Mm-hmm.
The certain ones, they go, oh, yeah, I love that. Yeah, they do.
Mm-hmm. Here's some more layout pieces. All right. Wow, wait. Turntable. The more engines and rolling stock, I think. That's a good thing they all come in separate things. That way you don't have to buy another set. That's nice.
Little planes. I like this
one. Oh. The old cars are cool too, though. I like the planes too. Those are cool.
Stickers coming out of that one, but.
Yeah. Ooh, little Sarge soldier men.
2 years ago, we both called. A friend of ours, he did the thing up there. He had passed away. Unbelievable. Just like that. Like we saw him like a few days before, and then gone. Did I pick up any more mock sets at all?
Oh, that. And a model train book. It's 2024 and 2025. That's nice. Ooh, I think this is Rio Grande right here. Down here we have a whole bunch of other train DVDs that you can buy here.
My bad. He's a kid like Josh's age.
Wait, is it?
That's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah.
Something like that in Alaska.
Ooh, Winnipesaukee.
Conway.
Oh, Conway Scenic, that's right, yeah. Rail Fans Weekend. Wow. More Conway Scenic stuff. And a bunch more train pictures galore here.
Oh, that
Edaville.
That's a nice color.
Yeah.
That one.
And look at this, Edaville.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
Massachusetts.
Edaville, oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. We should try the Edaville sometime. Tried Edaville. We're gonna try Edaville someday. That's where you can. There's even a Thomas train right there. That Thomas Land Edaville. You should check it out if you guys haven't been there. But anyway, here's some more rolling stock. the G-scale rolling stock. And all down here too. I swear, man, there are tubs and tubs and tubs of the stuff. It's insane. Geez, I wanna. Ooh. Old Thomas. I do like the old Thomas stuff. Yeah, I had a Terrence at one point. That's cool. I'm not gonna touch everything though. There's even some all engines go stuff here too. I hate all engines go. It's terrible. As you all know, every Thomas fan doesn't like all engines go because they suck. But here's some cooler rolling stock. The T. Oh yeah, old Ertl cars. Old Ooh, look at that. Tracks. And all kinds of other stuff. Okay, here's some tracks, some Lionel.
That's exactly
CSX train.
Yes.
Union Pacific. Right there, Union Pacific. It's a video. And these are locomotives. Here are even some Hot Wheel cars. I don't play with Hot Wheel cars anymore. Maybe some of my younger viewers do. And here we have the Blue Comet set. Is this a whole Blue Comet set?
Yeah.
Or all? Yeah. Nice. That is so cool. Man, I might...
Yeah, I don't know.
I might get a Blue Comet set maybe someday. And the reason why I'm not looking into model trains, I do like model trains, but it's just mainly work and school and all that stuff like that.
Oh, sure.
The Blue Comet engine itself. Look at that. Man, imagine owning one of them. Excuse me.
You can go ahead.
Excuse me. Union Pacific stuff and other rolling stock. At Union Pacific coach. Oh, wait, no, it's not. It's a different kind of coach. Here's some tracks. More Hot Wheel stuff. Lionel. The Ertl Lionel. Some engines over here even. 4266. That's the one at Conway Scenic Railroad, 4266. And over here, there's some... Oh, yeah, that is cool.
Makes it bright.
Mm-hmm. Wow. More line out rolling stock. Ooh, a daylight HO, I think. 4449 engine. Lionel tracks again. and some more Lionel stuff all the way down there. And right over here, we have more rolling stock over here. I wonder what happened to that race car track. That race car track. I don't know where or well. All right, here's I think this is all HO trains and other toys. Oh wow, that's a beauty.
Actually, we'll do that now.
A whole bunch of other cars. I guess you guys are ready to go, huh?
Who's ready to go? I'm not going anywhere. What are you talking about?
No,
we're just hanging out.
We're checking all the train stuff. I love the trains.
I love trains.
Yeah, me too.
I love the Lego.
Oh, I think we missed this thing. A fire station and some Western pieces.
Yeah.
A big boy 4014 locomotive. Another Union Pacific train. And some more rolling stock and engines. Oh, I think these are all engines.
Lots of them, huh?
Mm-hmm. Here's some more of the toys. Those are Paw Patrol stuff, Thomas, and another thing. Thomas. Oh,
you don't have like
that scratched up.
I had it unless someone bought it. There was one over.
Yeah.
Oh really?
Alrighty. Thomas, hey there.
What's up, dude?
How much
are you?
Look at all this. Oh, wow.
I'm sorry, honey, what'd you say?
Checking out some more. Okay. So we already been to this area. Oh, man.
I would say Patrick.
Oh, I'm sweating in this thing. And there's all toys up down.
It's all over. Yeah, yeah. That mouse is really nice. So I try to stay to the modern stuff. Otherwise, I'm collecting everything.
Yeah, you don't stand with the cannon on it.
No.
Usually it's a prototype. Like
yep. This. But you got priced accordingly.
Kinds of stuff on the walls, too.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
I think most of it's been taken, though. Paw Patrol stuff, Disney stuff too, I think.
Look at the bunnies.
Look at how soft.
Feel them. Whoa. That is soft.
Look at all that.
Planes. SpongeBob, I'm not a fan of SpongeBob.
See, Bailey, I love him. Bailey mm-hmm. had those ears off in no time.
Ooh. Some of these trains in rolling stock. That's G scale?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No, oh. Mm-hmm. Oh. G and O. Oh, we never saw this much. I think these are handmade, too. These are probably handmade too.
Yeah, they're beautiful, yeah.
nice. Very nice.
Wow.
Very cool.
Some wooden...
We need a,
I think those are wooden trains?
We needed a sort of an elevated
Look at those. Those are puzzles.
Yeah. I think there's a coffee pot engine. I'm not that sure.
It's kind of cool.
I think that's an old circus train.
Yeah? But the color on your camera is really good.
I don't actually know what I'm looking for.
This... Wow.
I'll get the drum guy.
Oh, Hess truck. I didn't realize my light was on.
440K. That's a blood angel.
I was waiting for my change when we can go.
They're vampires.
Did you see enough?
That's a gene stealer.
Oh, yeah. They got Thomas, songs playing in the background, which I hope I don't get copyrighted for.
guys, that wraps up this video. Make sure to leave a like, subscribe, smash the bell so you don't miss a single video. And we'll be doing this again in November. And see you guys next time. Peace.
testing the microphone. I forget what the heck the audio at. Look on my stream. Now I'm going to try and get the music ready. What? Oh, God. Well, I guess no mic. I guess no microphone. as soon as I have problems with music. It doesn't run properly until... I can't believe that. Really? Better?
Copyright free, William. It's just an NCS, non-copyright songs. If you just search that up in YouTube, there's tons of different playlists that comes up. That's what we got. What time is movie night? It is at 5:30 Eastern time. Or no, that's not right. 8:30 Eastern time. 8:30 Eastern time. So 5:30 Pacific time. So in an hour. I am buying ice cream from McDonald's with Uber Eats. Awesome Joe. It's good. Who's hyped, guys? Yes. My time is 6:30. So are you in Central Time, Crystal? So if that's the case, that is 7:30 your time. Thank you.
How's the stream looking? Looks like it's working just fine. Thank you.
gonna move my mic over here. So we can. I'm gonna turn on my other PC over here. I can see the chat.
Thank you.